Pinfari. Yep, where do I even start? In 1926, Pinfari was founded in Suzzara, Italy. The same year, they immediately started making vehicles for bumper car rides, which alone were a pretty new concept at the time, crashing round into people, just like the company did as a whole in 2004. In 1954, they started making coasters with an unconventional masterpiece, a wild mouse, which looked like it was literally gonna find your location, stab you to death, and default dance on your body. Although it was a steel leisure machine, I can't guarantee it wouldn't. In 1965, they created one of the largest portable ride models ever. Designed for rotating fairgrounds and ride holders, the Pinfari Zyklon grew massively with parks for their cheap cost and easy construction. If you're curious why they were so cheap, just Google the ride model and click images. Okay, just a quick break here. The older Pinfari rides, especially the Zyklon-style models, had some of the strangest track quality ever. It was literally thinner than modern Apple products. Quite honestly, the sketchiest roller coasters ever. There were, strangely, four entirely different Zyklon models, which were incredibly, practically the same as the rest. The Z47, Z64, Z78, the Z40, and lastly, I forgot the Z, this company is shockingly uncreative. Continuing the Zyklon theme, they also created a line of models named Roller Coaster. Okay, remember how I called Pinfari uncreative earlier? Just listen to the names of the models. RC40, RC48, RC50, and the RC70. I'm not joking, who made the names for these? They did a literal terrible job. Not only are the names shockingly uncreative, they are so unidentifiable. Not surprisingly, the RC70 actually went on to be named one of the worst coasters ever built. In the mood to crash and bash your skull into the hard, bulky, unpadded restraints on a somewhat forceful ride, the RC70 is a perfect ride for you. A good majority of the last Pinfari rides made were actually Wacky Worms, a very small ride model made for small children. What a great way to end. In 2004, Pinfari was liquidated and acquired by Interpark, who continues to sell the original Pinfari models. They also make some of their own inspired by what used to be the super sketchy coasters of Pinfari. Interpark, as well, makes parts to keep the rides up. Pinfari, a company who started early and ended in such a weird way, it would be hard to imagine where they'd be now.